Today we're going to be talking about watch list management. Now, you know, creating a bunch of lists of stocks, I mean, it might seem simple, but especially right now, I mean, 2020, 2021, there's so many stocks, so many sectors, so many setups out there that I think, you know, managing data, managing your watch list is very important. You got to have some structure to spot these moves or you're going to miss it. All right, everyone, before we get started, be sure to like, share, and subscribe to the channel. If someone sent you this video, hit that subscribe button. And then also, if you're on YouTube particularly, ring that bell to be notified as soon as we drop a new video or when we go live. Go live at least once a day, sometimes even more often. Want you to be notified as soon as we drop that new video or go live. All right, let's get started. So, watch lists, all right? Might seem boring, but I think that one. But I think that some of this. I don't care what it is. It's a lot of the boring work. You know, I tell the story. Well, I don't. I mean, many people tell these stories or these analogies. I like to think of like the NFL quarterback. You know, whether it be Tom Brady or somebody else. I mean, ultimately, an NFL quarterback. You can fact check me. I think they're on the field like an hour. You know, an hour on Sunday. On the field, you know, doing something with the football. But then you think, wait, there's 6 hours and or 6 days and 23 hours in every week. What are they doing? You know, how do they get to that championship level? How do they be consistent winners? It's what you do. It's the boring stuff. It's the, you know, it's the in the weight room. It's the nutrition. It's the watching the film. And I think watch lists are a lot like that because, you know, you've got to be able to keep track of the biggest movers, to keep track of multi-day movers. I mean, here we are on a Friday, right now I'm recording, you know, RHE. This was a, you know, sketchy Friday squeezer. You'll wonder why I love Friday squeezes so much. I mean, here we are middle of the day and it's already gone from, you know, the lows of 15 to as high as 28 and it's hanging around VWAP. There's a reason. So, but anyway, you know, the stock did nothing yesterday. It's had those flatline days. So if you don't have these on your watch, sometimes you'll forget about them. And you might forget that, oh, hey, wait a minute. RHE this morning, you know, in pre-market, you know, it closed yesterday at 1498. This morning in pre-market, it's at 1580, which isn't any huge percentage gain. So it's probably not going to show up on any of your big gainer scanners. But you don't want to forget about this stock. Because once it breaks the previous day's highs, and even once it broke 19, which was the high from earlier in the week, I mean, look at what happens when it breaks 19, that closing high from earlier in the week. Straight up, I mean, you can see my alert right there, basically straight up to 24. I mean, that's a nice move, and not that you're going to catch it all, but maybe you grab 50 cents or a dollar or $2. And even if you got a small account, a couple hundred shares, that's a nice gain in a matter of minutes. But again, you might have forgotten about this stock if you didn't have it on watch. So let's talk about the how I accomplished this and the best way I think to manage this, okay? Number one, I want you having a watch list broke down by sectors. And, you know, whether that be electric vehicles, whether that be low float stocks, whether that be crypto related stocks, because what the nice thing about that is, you'll know this, we call it the head of the snake, okay? Quite frequently, like for EVs, a good example, you know, you might not trade Tesla, a $600, $700, $800, $900 stock, but when Tesla's moving, all of the other crappy little penny stocks start to move. And we see that in so many sectors. So if you've got that list and then all of a sudden you hear the news or you see a tweet or breaking news drop something that says, hey, Tesla's up big today, you immediately know, hey, I need to jump to my EV list and see what's going on. Weed stocks, you know, TLRY and ACB, weed stocks had a merger today. Of course, weed stocks went nowhere because weed stocks are the most annoying sector ever in the last couple of years. But that being said, at some point, Someday before I die, there will be another weed stock run. It hasn't happened for 4 years now, but it'll happen. But that being said, you know, like, let's say the president goes on, has a press conference, starts talking about weed. You can't, that's not the time to be sitting there trying to dig up all these weed tickers. I mean, it's too late. I mean, these stocks move fast. So if you have these lists prepared based on the sectors, I mean, the other day, speaking of the president, they started talking about lowering nicotine requirements on cigarettes. Cigarette plays, low nicotine plays start running. This stuff happens over and over again. And if you're doing that work in the film room, if you got all these watch lists built, okay, you're a step ahead of the next guy, the next girl, and you're making that trade when everybody else is scrambling, trying to find that low float weed stock or that cigarette stock or that EV stock or that crypto stock or coronavirus stock. You know, those are all watch lists that I have that I can go to. NFTs. I mean, the NFT plays run together. Now, how do you do that? I mean, you know, one of my favorite sayings, you know, the best time to plant a tree is 20 years ago. Second best time is today. You know, just start now. I mean, if anything, create these sectors I've talked about. Start adding the tickers. When you see the gainers, when you see RHE, you know, a low float Amex stock. I mean, these run together. Start building your low float Amex stock. This ran with BTX. There's a bunch of them that are moving with it as well. So start today. Just start building those lists. And I know, everyone just wants to make money. Everyone wants to make trades. But I'm telling you. Yeah, and I'll go back to my Tom Brady analogy. Everyone wants to throw touchdowns, okay? Everyone wants to throw 3, 4, 5 touchdowns a game. But, you know, and everyone wants to make 3, 4, 5 thousand, 50,000, 100,000. I mean, but you don't get there without putting in the work. So start building those watch lists, start building those sectors, and it's going to get you in those trades quicker, okay? Now, next thing I want to talk about, you'll hear me talk about my rolling watch list methodology, okay? And that's a great example, again, talking about something like RHE. So I have a Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday watch list of the most active day trade type setups, okay? So today, Friday, you can see I've got BTX, EARS, IBIO, LEDS, and RHE. You can see over here on my watch list, okay? All big gainers. Well, LEDS isn't, but LEDS was a huge gainer the last 2 days. That's a Friday watch too. See, you know, again, you're not gonna, that's a great example. LEDS is probably my number one afternoon watch, but it's red on the day. So it's not going to show up on any of your percent gainer scans, or it's not going to show up on Oracle, or it's not going to show up on the new high day list. It's down 11%, but I don't want to forget about that stock. So every single day I come in, one of the very first things I do, like today, I go to my Friday watch list and I start clicking through every stock in that watch to see which ones are still holding up, which ones still have strong charts. If it's a stock that's at or around the highs, quote unquote, hanging around, then I keep it. If it's a stock that, say, collapsed yesterday or even collapsed 2 or 3 days ago, I delete it off my watch. So now I start Friday with, you know, the one or two, you know, BTX is one of them, stocks that are still hanging up from last Friday. I delete everything else. Then I jump back to Thursday and I do the same thing. So now Thursday, the previous day's watch list, I'm looking at all those daily charts, seeing which ones are still in play, which ones have news, which ones are gapping up. You know, a lot of my previous day watches are going to be gappers. So if that stock is gapping, then I, you know, with StocksToTrade or, I mean, really any platform you can do this, I right-click that ticker and I roll it over to Friday. So now I've got my stocks that have held up all week to date. 5 day to date, I've got every stock that closed strong on Thursday and is now gapping up. So now I've got that template of those stocks that are particularly good short squeezes, because the longer they hang around, the more likely they are to squeeze. So that's how I start every day. That's that rolling watch list methodology. Start with the previous day, or not previous day, the previous week today. So today, start with Friday. I clean up that watch. I keep the lone survivors. Then I jump back to Thursday and I add those. And then if you want, you know, which it's funny, I used to do this. You know, I used to go back 2-3 days sometimes in order to build a big enough watch list. You know, in 2020 and 2021, you do the week to day and then the previous day, and usually got like 15 stocks. But anyway, let's say we go back to a normal time. I would do that same thing and keep rolling back and looking for those stocks that have been hanging around. So now I've got that list. Now I proceed to start running my scans. Okay. And you can check out, I mean, I've got tons of videos on the scans I run, what I look for, etc. So I'm looking for those first green days. You should all know that pattern, that idea. So these are all day oneers. Okay. So these stocks aren't going to show up on the week old watch list or the day old watch list because they're big gainers today, started running today, have news, first green days. Then I add those all in. Then I'm going to sort by volume. And then I'm going to start breaking down the criteria with that day trade worksheet that I talk about all the time. So now, let's say I've got 6 stocks or 10 stocks or 12 stocks. I sort by volume and I start doing my worksheets to find the best 2 or 3. Okay. Because I think that's something that so many people have always screwed up, you know, trying to trade and watch too many stocks. But I think it's doubly exacerbated by the markets we're in right now. I mean, one of the biggest things you have to focus on, is focus. Didn't come out the way I wanted, but you know what I mean. You know, ultimately, getting down to a manageable number of stocks for you. Now, listen, maybe you've been gaming your whole life and you got like crazy eye-hand coordination and you can watch 30 stocks at a time. I would doubt that. Multitasking is a myth. But maybe you can do that. I doubt it. But maybe you can manage 10, maybe you can manage 5, maybe you can manage 1. I mean, especially if you're at work, you know, I always say I won't tell your boss if you're trading at work. You can always trust me not to tell your boss. But, you know, but seriously, if you're busy, if you've got a project or you're working from home, you're working on something or the kids are in the room or maybe you're back to the office and you're working, you can't. I mean, it's impossible. You're going to screw up everything if you're trying to trade 5-10 stocks. So do your worksheets, dial it down, get down to, in my opinion, my goal is always in the morning, I want 2 or 3 focus stocks and then 2 or 3 focus afternoon VWAP hold type setups. You know, so basically a total of 6 stocks, 3 morning setups, 3 afternoon setups. Not saying it always works out like that. Sometimes it's none, sometimes it's 1, sometimes it's 10, okay, especially right now. But the goal is to get down to that manageable number that I'm not distracted and I'm not missing everything. You know, I've said it on this channel so many times, but one of my favorite non-trading quotes is by Confucius, "He who chases many rabbits catches none." And I think that the watch list methodology and the day trade worksheet can really help you out with that. So, all right, let me know. Drop me a comment. How many watch lists do you have? I have so many I lose count at times, but I've literally got years of watch lists. I've got some in Google Docs that I keep. I've got Excel spreadsheets of old watch lists. I've got Evernote. I've got StocksToTrade. I've got all these tools tracking watch lists. But I think that that's that film room work that can really make a difference. And then as always, if you're curious about how to fill out that day trade worksheet or that swing trade worksheet or that short selling worksheet, these are all processes and techniques that I go over every single day in the Steady Trade team. So if you're out there kind of wandering in the wilderness, trying to find your way on your own, I'm glad you're watching these videos. I love doing this. But if you're looking to kind of get that focus and really take your education to the next level, definitely check out the Steady Trade team twice a day, every single day, working with you live and in chat. And it's a great mentorship program. Click the link below, and I look forward to working with you.